We've moved on from the days when the idea of a fair division of labor in the kitchen was based on women cooking and men eating. And there's no such thing as gender profiling when it comes to culinary skills. Naturally, it does help if both partners are reading from the same page of the recipe book. And Durban-based power couple, Koobeshen and Kumseela Naidu, have embarked on a new project to help achieve harmonious cooking. Koobeshen and Kumseela are combining their skills as educators and entertainers to stage cookery classes for couples. So let's see what's on the menu.
Comedian and actor Koobeshen Naidu finds endless inspiration for humor in the complexities of family life. Whether they're enjoying the Kandasamy saga on screen or the dingalings on stage, audiences are kept in stitches by Koobeshen's portrayal of men who can never quite understand women.
Hey, don't be silly, lady. You can't get... Listen to Henry, he'll explain to you.
Yeah. Marriage is bad for you.
His wife, Kumseela, offers an equally funny take from a female perspective. But in real life, they're a couple whose relationship has lasted more than 3 decades.
From the big screen to the small screen to the theatre stage, you'll easily recognise Koobeshen and Kumseela as actors and comedians. But this husband and wife are taking their skill and chemistry into the kitchen with their new concept, Love at First Bite. And I'm spending the day with them as they prepare a meal for their friends. I cannot wait, and I'm sure it's going to be full of laughs. Let's go.
Hi, Kurusha. Hi, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
No problem, come in. We've already started with lunch.
Thank you. It's beautiful. Welcome.
Lovely to see you again.
Nice to see you too. The last time I saw you guys was at Dingalings. How did that go?
Very well, actually. We sold out all the shows, so it went pretty well.
And exceedingly well received. Yeah. Lovely.
Oh, of course. No surprise there.
Oh, thank you.
So from the theatre stage to the kitchen, tell me about this.
I have two passions. The one is cooking and the other is theatre.
No, it's
and
me.
Oh, sorry.
And passion.
Two passions, Koobeshen, passion of cooking and theatre. So what we've done is we've actually amalgamated three wonderful ideas to make a whole new concept, Love at First Bite.
Of course, both of you are teachers at heart. Kumseela, you're still a teacher. Do you find that this show is going to help you teach yourselves as well as others about cooking and relationships?
I think one of the ways we've always found that when we get home from school, kick off our shoes, and the common time that we have almost always before we sort of crash is in the kitchen preparing the meal. So we thought, what better idea than to teach people? You've got the time and the space and the necessity to develop a relationship in the kitchen preparing wholesome home-cooked meals.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for having me in your home and allowing me to watch as you prepare your meal.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Go for it. We're doing a creamy peri-peri prawn starter. You need to season this with the lovely Himalayan pink salt, and we have some chili flakes. Do you know how much to put in?
Until it's covered, I see.
Just a wee bit, I think. I'm going to put a little bit of the oil into the pan. And then we're going to add some butter in here because it is a creamy starter. And then we're going to add some pepper, just a little wee sprinkle of it, into the sauce, what is a store-bought peri-peri sauce, a cup of it. And I've added to this 1 cup of heavy cream. And we're going to give this a stir. We have an absolutely creamy sauce that's so well combined. And put in the prawn.
Okay, so
do you want to do that? They're butterflied prawns, and the advantage of that is that the flavor permeates the prawn very nicely. You did that exceptionally well.
I know. Well trained.
And then you're going to see that it's all coated. Finally, we're going to add some of the ghee. Just a little drizzle. And that's our prawn starter all done, and we're going to move on to the South Indian fish curry.
Ooh, spicy.
Now, what are we doing?
We're going to add the oil. You know why we're adding the oil first? Before we add the ghee, so that the ghee does not all boil. You're going to pass me the onion. Throw that in. Can you pass me the sprigs of curry leaves? I'm going to put 2 in there. I'm going to put 2 of the lovely chili in there.
Wow.
The jeera, 1 teaspoonful. Can you pass me this lovely braising spice with mustard seeds and curry leaves and dried onion, a whole spoonful of garlic, and a spoonful of minced ginger. Very good. I'm going to add a whole spoonful of salt and the chili powder, Kashmiri chili powder, the turmeric. Now, do you know what the advantage of using turmeric in all of our food is?
It makes the food yellow.
It does.
Okay.
But it's also a natural antiseptic and a natural anti-inflammatory.
Oh.
And then we need the tomato paste. This was the lovely tomatoes that you liquidized for us. I'm going to add it in very gently because we don't want it to spill. And we're going to give this a good stir. And now we're going to add the tamarind. I've put some hot water into it. And then you're going to add the lovely brown sugar because brown sugar is a little bit more friendly. It caramelizes easily. And it's now time to put in the fish. We haven't sealed in the fish. We're just putting raw fish in here. And the idea is that all of our beautiful gravy is going to be absorbed into this fish. We need to add the garam masala. Now we're going to very generously spoon this over.
Now you put chili powder, and now you're putting garam masala.
Yes, garam is derived from a Sanskrit word that means hot. Then we add the dhania. Coriander also aids digestion. This curry is done and our rice is done as well. I'm gonna get onto the dessert. If ever you're stressed for time and you need to serve a really stunning dessert to impress people, you need to do my kulfi.
Yum, my favorite. I love kulfi.
I love this little device. It's got all the nuts inside. And when we cover it, pull one. Open it and our nuts are all crushed. I'm going to start with the biscuits. I'm going to just crush some of them on top of the ice cream. I'm going to pick up my nuts and scoop some of that in here. I've got the grated chocolate. And I'm going to scoop that in. And last but not least, I've got a spoon of the cardamom, which I am going to sprinkle in. And then we give this a good mix and stick it in the freezer.
Wow.
Kulfi.
Can we have some now?
We'll have to wait.
It has been so much fun hanging out with you today. I know everyone is going to love watching this. What's next for the both of you?
Well, it's a love at first bite. The cookery classes for young couples or beginners or people like Koobeshen who don't know how to cook. And more theatre.
I have a flight to catch to Johannesburg. Your friends are so lucky to be tasting the food. But I am so grateful that I got to spend the day with you. Thank you, guys.
It was an absolute pleasure having you.
Timing is the essence of both comedy and hospitality. And Koobeshen and Kumseela had timed their preparations to perfection. They just finished plating when the guests arrived, so the meal was ready to be enjoyed right away.
Yeah, actually.
So you, what was the winning dish here today?
That's a tough one, but I reckon the prawns was a winner for me.